Just one night, all we got. Just one night, all we got. Just one night, all we got. Just one night, all we got.
I ain't got time for you, baby. Either you're mine or you're not. Make up your mind, sweet baby. Right here, right now is all we got. A little party never killed nobody. So we gon' dance until we drop, drop, drop.
Hey, do you really want to go skate night?
Not really.
No, me neither.
Skating bada pop. So us people who live in Cypress, we're kind of an older city, as in the people, the citizens around here. Like, we have some pretty elderly people around here, right? And it's true, like, it's nothing we can deny. It's just a nice little city that was built for these elderly, retired people to come up and live here. If we were trying to throw a party here at Cypress, we'd get busted like this. I mean, they try to go to sleep at 9 o'clock at night.
And then we
start playing our music, like insanely loud, and then they're gonna start calling the cops, and the cops are what, like 5 minutes away?
Cause
it's like,
we
go to Cypress Library, and right around the corner is the police station. They're gonna come within 5 minutes, and we're all gonna be like, screwed. I mean, we can't do anything about it.
Yeah. Oh, hey guys, so this Wednesday, my dad's gonna be home, but he said I can have friends over, and like, he doesn't care if you drink, if you guys want to come over before.
I can come over, but I'm not gonna drink because I got a dinner and then skate night.
Kendall, you're such a buzzkill.
I'm not going to skate night, but I'm still raging, that's for sure.
She's going to skate night with me.
We'll be fine.
Yeah. I mean,
I got a family dinner.
No,
I'm serious. Seriously, I can't be drunk for my family
dinner. Whatever. I'm pretty down. We'll be there.
All right, sounds good. Text your friends and then just invite people. All
right, yeah, we'll do.
And what happens at parties?
Stays at parties.
Stays at parties.
Thank you. Guys.
Well, here one, two, count me in.
Not a couple.
Right here, right here, ready?
Wait, wait, is that like the candy that's like soaked inside
yeah.
the
bottle?
Yeah. That's a cop, yo. What are you trying to call?
All right,
ready? Right.
This is revenge.
All right, guys, we have a problem. So my mom's coming by, and she's not okay with this, but my dad is. But we gotta clean all this up, and we gotta go before my mom gets here. So
that's pretty
mean.
That's pretty lame.
That's pretty
mean. To be
honest.
All right,
whatever. Let's go.
Whatever.
Hey.
What
do
you?
Party will continue somewhere else.
Stop it.
Leave it. Leave it.
Oh, you need to calm down.
Take my beer for the road.
Wait, wait. You're driving. Hey, don't let him leave.
What? You just took her beer. These
wait,
are my keys.
Wait,
I'm driving.
You cannot drive.
I am fine.
Can I just text my mom and can you just take me home and so she doesn't have to come here?
I'll take you home.
She didn't even clean up.
That's fine. I'll just text my mom and can you take me home.
Do you see my shoes, Kendall? Really?
Okay, we're good. Let's go.
Buzz,
those are
let's go.
Shoes.
Come on. Kendall, you'll be fine. Come on.
You're driving. Honestly, I'm like,
I really don't think I'm able to drive. Like, I'm not comfortable with
it. Do you want Michelle to drive? She's not my license.
Let's go. You're fine.
You know what? I'll drive.
Your car.
I'll drive.
Just get in the car.
I was gonna ask you in class the other day, did you ever figure out where you wanted to go for school?
I got accepted into Cal State Long Beach.
Oh, that's pretty cool. I got denied, so that's funny.
Well, do you know where you're gonna go?
Yeah, I'm have my heart set on like San Francisco State, so I'm just waiting until I can accept admission on April 1st.
Let's go, Kendall.
I literally can feel myself aging because of how slow.
Like I'd rather watch paint dry than watch and be in this car with you for another
concentrate
like,
for what? Literally, you're not moving fast enough to cause any damage
totally
to anyone.
Oh my God! Can you shut up?
What are you reporting?
There's been an accident at the community center. There's a lot of blood. People seem to be hurt. I don't know what to do.
Are there cars involved?
Yes, there's two.
Two cars? Do you know how many people are injured?
No, there's just a lot of blood.
Okay, we'll have police and paramedics on the way. Thank you.
Mike 2 with Mike 1, 103.
What?
Injury traffic collision in front of the community center. 5700 Orange. 5700 Orange. Units respond code 3.
Accident by community center. There's blood everywhere. I see some dude hanging out by the side of the car. I don't know what to do, but it's glass.
Okay, hold on a second. Are you at the community center?
Yes, on Orange.
On Orange? Okay, and how many vehicles are involved? Okay, and one hanging out of the vehicle, do we need paramedics? Okay, are you involved or you're a witness? Okay, what's your name?
John. I go here at this high school near.
Cypress High School?
Okay. And how many people are there in the vehicle?
Well, there's glass everywhere, but I don't know what to do.
Okay, that's okay. Just stay there. We have officers and paramedics on the way, okay? You're welcome.
Mike 2, I copy. All units respond code 3 of 79 initiating the SAR team. Orange County Fire is also now.
Only know you've been high when you're feeling low. Only hate the road when you're missing home. Only know you love her when you let her go. And you let her go.
How many drinks did you have again?
Only a few beers.
How many is a few?
Three.
Three? Is it a tall can, small cans?
Normal size.
It's a normal size. Anything else with it?
No.
Okay. On this last test, I'm going to ask you to do a PAS, which is a preliminary alcohol screening test, okay? Just like the TV, it's the little device you blow into, okay? Would you like to do that?
No, I don't
want to
do that.
You want to do that?
No.
Okay. It's all right. You'll have to. It's optional.
You're gonna put your hands behind your back. You're gonna lace your fingers. Spread your feet real wide for me. Real wide here.
Of your glass, hoping one day you'll make the dream last. The dreams come slow and they go so fast. You see when you close your eyes, maybe one day you'll understand why everything you touch surely dies. But you only need the light when it's burning low. Only miss the sun when it starts to snow. Only know you love her when you let her go.
Paige, can you hear me? Squeeze my fingers. Paige, squeeze my fingers. How about on this side? Can you squeeze my fingers? Can you hear me? You're in the hospital.
Only know you love her when you let her go. Staring at the ceiling in the dark. Same old empty feeling in your heart.
Hi, can I help you?
Yeah, I was told that my daughter Paige was in an auto accident and they don't know anything.
Okay, we're gonna come. I'll walk you to.
Okay.
Cause you loved her too much and you dive too deep. Well, you only need the light when it's burning low. Only miss the sun when it starts to snow. Only know you love
her. I just wanted to let you know, Paige was brought in. She was in an accident. And I want to let you know we did everything we could for as long as we could. But unfortunately, we were unable to bring her back.
Oh no, don't tell me that.
She passed away at 4 o'clock. I'm very sorry.
Say something, I'm giving up.
I'm so sorry for your loss.
I'll be the
I can't talk to my dad right now. He's not here right now.
Anywhere I would have followed.
Wait, can I see her?
Of course. Come with me.
Mr. Bouchard?
Actually, it's Borchard.
Mr. Borchard, can you step in and talk to me for a minute?
Sure.
Do you have a daughter, Michelle?
I do.
Okay. Did she have a party here today?
I believe so. I don't know. I was upstairs. I have no idea.
People that were here at that party were drinking, and there has been a
fatal accident in relation to the people that were drinking here. Do me a favor, turn around. Put your hands behind your back.
Sure.
Interlace your fingers for me.
What's going on?
I'll explain everything here in a second. Mr. Borchard, because you allowed minors to drink here and it resulted in someone being killed, you're being arrested for aiding and abetting in manslaughter.
Are you serious?
Yep.
Great bodily injury. The jurors have now been excused. Before I pronounce sentence, is there anything you would like to say?
I was never meant to be driving the car. My friend, he was a lot more drunk than I was, and he was going to get in the car no matter what. And I thought I was doing the right thing. I thought I was focusing on protecting my friends. And I wasn't thinking about the people that I was putting at risk. I just thought I was doing the right thing. This is not something that I would have done like regularly. I'm a D1 athlete. I have a scholarship. My whole life is planned out, and I didn't mean to, and I'm sorry.
The lack of personal responsibility you're taking, Ms. Bowdish, shocks the conscience. The thing about driving under the influence with alcohol is there are a lot of similarities to school shootings in that people who happen to randomly be in front of a bullet are at risk of death. It's the same thing with driving under the influence. Any car that happens to be on the street that night, the person is, unbeknownst to them, subject to be hit and subjected to great bodily injury or death. The other dynamic about driving under the influence is it doesn't matter how wonderful of a person you are. And unlike many other types of crimes, driving under the influence is amazingly selfish because it's premeditated. You know when you're going in advance when you're going to be drinking. And there are alternatives. There are designated drivers. There are taxis. There's Uber. There's no excuse whatsoever. Despite the fact that you had great things planned for your life, you are too much of a risk to put back on the street. Three people have been killed. Two other have been significantly wounded. I am going to impose my discretion to sentence you to life in prison without the possibility of parole. Your sentence will be forthwith.
It's just a ride on the wheel. listen.